Real good to be here with you folks tonight, and hopefully enjoy some of the old time mountain music they call bluegrass music. And we're going to do our best to entertain you. We want to thank you for such good treatment we've had since we've been over here. Thank you for a good audience tonight. We're going to do the best we can. I'll introduce you to the Clinch Mountain Boys as they come up, pick and sing for you. And the young man that did the Lost Train Blues there is from the great state of North Carolina. Give Dewey Brown a nice hand. Thank you. And over on the bass fiddle is a young man from the state of Tennessee. You know, Jack Cook, he's been over here with me for four or five times, but I'd like to tell you, Jack is not really able to travel anymore, so he couldn't make this trip. And this young man right here is doing a fine, good job. And give Audie Ratliff a nice hand on the bass. This makes him probably three or maybe four times that he's been to England with me. He does a wonderful job. Been playing the banjo about 15 years, I believe. And of course, he's a good old-time Kentucky boy. And give Steve Sparkman a great big hand. fine, Steve. You know, that's exactly the way I would have tried to play it about 50 years ago. Good job. Now on the lead guitar, and I guess the rhythm both, he's doing two jobs tonight. He's been with me a long time, I reckon about 15 years now. And how many trips you been over here with me?
This is my third one.
Third one. He's been over here three times, so you glad to have him. He's our road manager and sort of, you know, high sheriff and
bodyguard,
commonwealth attorney, and whatever. Whatever we need while he's ready. He's from the state of Tennessee, and his name is James Shelton.
Here's a Bob Dylan song for you. This is the latest cut off of my new CD. It's called Walking Down the Line. Well, I'm walking down the line. I'm walking down the line. Walking down the line. Feet to be a flying. Tell them about my trouble. I got a heavy head, gal. I got a heavy head, gal. She ain't feeling well, and she better only time to tell. Well, I'm walking down the line. I'm walking down the line. Walking down the line, feet to be a fly. Tell them about my trouble. Standing center stage and been heading up this band since 1946. He started in this business with his brother Carter as the Stanley Brothers in 1946. And if my arithmetic's right, I think that adds up to 63 years in this business. I think he deserves a hand. During that time, there's been a lot of honors, accomplishments, and awards that he's very proud of, and I'd like to name just a few of them. In 1976, he received the Honorary Doctorate of Arts degree from Lincoln Memorial University in Harrogate, Tennessee, and that's how he got the name Dr. Ralph Stanley. Then in 1984, the President of the United States gave him the National Heritage Award. In 2000, he was named a living legend by the Library of Congress. And in 2002, he received three Grammy Awards for his work on the soundtrack to the movie, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? And I'm sure a lot of you have seen that. In 2004, his home state honored him by naming him Virginian of the Year. And I think just last year, he was also named Outstanding Virginian of the Year. He has his own museum in Clintwood, Virginia, and I could just go on and on, but the bottom line is a true pioneer in bluegrass music, a man that has helped set the standard for all the bands that you hear out there on the road today, and I have never met a finer gentleman or heard a finer singer or banjo player than this gentleman standing beside of me. How about a big England welcome for Dr. Ralph Stanley?
63 years, will be in October, and during that time I've helped record, I know 250 CDs, and a lot of them have been gospel songs. I'm a believer in God, and I like to do gospel songs, and I'd like to do you one right now that I wrote back in the middle 80s and recorded it in the middle ages. I'll answer the call. Like appreciate that. Now I'd like to call James Shelton up here now. As far as being a good singer, well, he knows how to what to do with that guitar. Plays the lead guitar in all of our records and all of our shows and everything. So, James, give us a good instrumental there.
All right, how about a little Soldier's Joy?
A little Soldier's Joy, that's good. Favorite gospel song that I sang, and the name of this one is A Robin Built a Nest on Daddy's Grave. Song. much. Everybody said it's real hot on this stage. I'm freezing. No, I'm just joking about that, but it's not as hot as I figured it would be. So right now, I believe we're going to call Dewey Brown back up here with the old-time fiddle. And Dewey, where you is? You get me a bottle of water. Well, God bless you. You know, Dewey, you do a tune that I really like called Lost John.
Yes, sir. I've got that on record out here. Just
yes, you have. Could you do that?
I would be glad to do that. The Lost John.
Good. I don't believe I could have beat that. So I won't try. Folks, we're short tonight on a man. I've got a grandson, 16 years old, going on 40. And he had a passport, and my wife, his mammo, about a year ago, washed that passport up in the washing machine. So he had to order him another one, and he didn't get it back in time, but I talked back home, I believe, today or yesterday, and he got his passport on Tuesday morning, the day after we left. So I'd like for you to heard him, and then, of course, my son, you know, Ralph, second, he's been over here with us, but he's sort of got a band of his own now. And they're doing some semi-country, you know. It's still traditional music. So I'm still dragging along, picking along the old-time way. I have something in mind that I wanted to do, and I can't think what it was. I'm getting forgetful, folks, here lately. Well, first, I'm 82 years old. And James asked me how forgetful I was. Well, I'll tell you what. I got scared about 6 months ago, and I went to the doctor. And I told him, you know, that I couldn't remember like I used to. And he said, how long have you been that way? And I said, what way? A little boy called Joe. In a war-torn land of poverty, somewhere across someone, you're just a little boy called Joe. Just a little boy called Joe, like so many more I know. Lived all alone somewhere across the sea. I want him to have my name. Little Joe is mine to claim. A little boy called Joe belongs to me. Steve Spartan. Yeah. Yeah. Steve, I believe you're in the band.
All right, well,
we'll
be glad to feel that.
And I know you can feel that.
Do the Clinch Mountain Backstab.
Yeah! Yeah. What am I supposed to do next? I told you I was getting forgetful. James Shelton wanted me to do The Girl from the Greenbrier Shore. I recorded that in about, while I was on the tour of Old Brother, Where Art Thou? And it's been a long time since I sung it, and I don't know, I may forget it, but if I do, forgive me, okay? And remember, I'm forgetful. Chose that girl Out of the show, it messes you up.
Do Little Maggie?
Yeah, Little Maggie. I recorded Little Maggie a long time. Yeah, okay, Little Maggie. This song, we've done it a long time, and it's called Amazing Grace. And I'd like to tell you about the Amazing Grace. I remember my mother took me to church when I was 4 years old. She rode a horse on the church, went to a Primitive Baptist church, and they sung Amazing Grace. And there's a good crowd there, and everybody in the church house sung. But the preacher got up on the stand and lined out the words to that song. The reason he did that, is everybody didn't have a songbook and they didn't know the words, so he lined it and they knew exactly what to say. And we'll try that one right now. And the reason that they have one songbook that I've heard now that they couldn't afford any more songbooks, so you know that's getting hard up.
Tell you about Ralph Stanley's 40th Annual Memorial Bluegrass Festival that comes up on Memorial Day weekend in the United States. It's the Thursday, Friday, and Saturday before the last Monday in the month of May. And of course, that just happened last weekend, so if you didn't go last week, you missed it. But we want to tell you about it so you'll be aware for next year. And we're going to have a great lineup, as always, for you. We have people like Larry Sparks and the Lonesome Ramblers and Gillian Welch and Jim Lauderdale and Paul Williams and, of course, Ralph Stanley all 3 days. And it's just a great time, a great weekend. And if you like this old-time mountain-style bluegrass music, you would really love to come and see where it all started up on the Smith Ridge, the Stanley Family Farm up in southwestern part of Virginia. So keep that in mind, May 27th, 28th, and 29th. I know it's a ways off, but just something to think about. And I would like to tell you a few things we have for sale, and I'll be honest with you, we just don't have much left. We couldn't pack too much in the suitcase coming over on the airplane. And I think Ralph is probably sold completely out of all of his albums. But you can go to his website, www.drralphstanley.com, and he has some albums on there that you can't buy in any store. They're not available anywhere. He's got the last live recording the Stanley Brothers ever did at Bean Blossom, Indiana, 1966. He's got one from 1969 in Berryville, Virginia, Watermelon Park, with Larry Sparks on guitar. And he's got one called Now and Then, 25 of Ralph's most popular songs. And as I said, you can't buy these anywhere except directly from the man himself. And Ralph, you want to tell the folks here in Bath tonight why you did it that way?
Yeah, you see, ladies and gentlemen, that way I make all the profit.
Audie Ratliff here on bass is really a mandolin player. He builds mandolins in Churchill, Tennessee. If you've ever heard of the Ratliff mandolins, this is the gentleman that makes every one of them. And he just turned out number 1,000. He's been working on the mandolin since about 1982, and he has a new CD out called A Piece of Cake that features his mandolin playing and singing. And Dewey Brown's got some good fiddle records back there. He's got a brand new one called Hard Times for a Fiddler that has got some real good fiddle tunes. After I build you up, now you tell me yourself.
I got the other.
Okay. Well, he's got his first album anyway, if he is sold out of that one. With Lost John, the tune we did a little earlier. Steve, you got anything left?
I've sold out of DVDs and CDs. If anybody might be interested in one of the new DVDs we have, I'll be glad to give them a card for the website where they can order one.
Okay. All right, the banjo that Steve is holding is the Hills of Home model Stanley Tone banjo built by Frank Need in Russell Springs, Kentucky. And if you followed Ralph's career down through the years, you know that he's sold Stanley Tone banjos probably for the last 30 years. This is number 11 of 25 of the Hills of Home model that are going to be made. And this particular banjo that we have with us on stage tonight is for sale, and you could actually take it home with you. It's the last one, but now you're going to have to come to Manchester tomorrow night to pick it up, because we've got to have it on the last show. I've got my guitar albums out there. I don't have but just a couple left. So after the show, if you would just come back and shake and howdy with us and just take a look at what all we have left. And what a wonderful, beautiful town you have here in Bath. And we have really enjoyed our stay here and hope that we can wait our turn and come back again. Thank you very much.
I played the banjo in this band for over 50 years. And about 15 years ago, there was a young man by the name of Steve Sparkman came along and shot me out of the saddle. So I don't get to play the banjo much anymore, but you know, the first way I learned to play, my mother taught me when I was just a little bitty boy 10 years ago, or 10 years. And she taught me to play what I call the claw hammer. And any time that I'm on a show and get a request, I always do one of them claw hammers, you know. Anytime I get a request. Thank you. Does anybody have a request?
Need to take on tomorrow.
And somebody I can hear.
Here today, gone tomorrow.
Oh, no, Pretty Polly!
Pretty Polly? He's got to tune that up. If you got it, you know, I sung what did I play there? See, I shot Little Luli in that old time sawmill key, I call it. So Steve has to put that back in regular G tuning, you know, to do Pretty Polly. But I've sung Pretty Polly many a time. You were going to quit picking the banjo and move to Florida and start farming.
Well, you heard half of that, right?
I heard half of that right.
Yeah, I'm not going to quit playing the banjo, but I am going to Florida to do some farming for a while.
Well, I know you lived in Florida the biggest part of last year. I know you did some farming, and I know you raised some good crops. But would you give me a few crops that you raised last night that it might pay you to go down there?
Well, yeah, we done so good. We had two or three of them, but one of them was peanuts.
Peanuts?
We raised peanuts as big as your fist.
Oh, those big peanuts. What do you give credit for that, Steve?
Climate.
Climate?
Climate.
You got another one?
Yes, sir. We raised some sweet potatoes.
Sweet potatoes?
They were some of those sweet potatoes, 30 pounds. They can fix this banjo.
Oh, have mercy, 30 pounds. What'd you give a reason for that?
Credit, climate.
Climate?
Climate.
One more.
All right, we got the world record on the watermelon.
World record?
We got one watermelon so big it took a flat car to hold it.
What'd you give credit for that?
Climate.
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 Climate. You know, I don't know why, but that made me think of something when we was talking. You remember Audie's, he had a little girl back years ago. I believe her name was Sophronie Finkelsquirt.
That's right.
And I know that's been years ago. And then Dewey Brown, you remember that little short boy he had?
Yeah, Shorty, I remember him.
Well, he's 4 feet and 2 inches tall right now. I saw him not long ago. They're grown, you know, and he's 4 feet and 2 inches. And the girl, James, her...
Audie.
Audie's girl is 6'10". And you know what?
What's that?
They got married 2 weeks ago.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Her 6'10", him 4'2", and they got married.
Him 6'10", and her 4, I mean, her 6'10", and him 4'2".
Oh, I wonder what he does when he goes to kiss her.
Climb it. Now, James Shelton, I believe you have one of the two for the folks.
Yeah. I'd like to do another guitar tune here. Here's one called John Henry, the Steel Driving Man.
Enjoyed our show tonight.
Yeah. Yeah!
Well, we've done the very best that we know how to do the best that we could. And I know, and I say every one of you all knows, that you know the people in the audience is what makes a good show. And you all have been them people tonight. If this has been a good show, you folks are responsible for it. Because you made us feel welcome, you made us feel at home. And I've never been treated any better than right here in England, and I appreciate it. I guess if I ever go through with, you know, natural being born again, I'm going to see if I can't have it done in England. After Dewey Brown does the Orange Blossom Special, we're gonna close out our show. And like I say, we're really glad to be here, and we hope you've enjoyed it. We've done our best, and I don't know what I met a nicer audience. And we wanna thank you for it. After Dewey Brown does the Orange Blossom Special, we're going to say good night to you. So long. God bless you, and God bless England. Thank you very much. Hey, that train's got a cold. Thank you very much. You know what I think? Anybody that'll stand up and applaud for a band like that deserves one more song. Yeah.